Warp Thru is inspired by Super Crate Box, and it really shows. Just watch me hop around this arena collecting portals. It feels so similar. The game has small arenas that can spawn a ton of monsters, and it plays in the same frantic way as Super Crate Box. So if you're not cleaning up the monsters, you're in for a rough time. I've covered a few other games that take inspiration from Super Crate Box, and Warp Thru is the most unique. Anyway, instead of crates, you're collecting portals that fuel research, which unlocks future levels. The arenas are basic, and the screen wrapping can be frustrating. Again, if you're not cleaning up the monsters, it's difficult to keep track of them all. You'll end up jumping to a new platform just as a monster is flying in from the top of the screen. It's that tricky balance between killing monsters and collecting the portals. There are two things that make Warp Thru stand out. The first is the attack. You must stand still briefly to charge up before your next move will unleash an attack in the direction you move. Keep in mind, it doesn't make you invincible, and I've died attacking in the wrong direction. While the game clearly shows when the attack is charged, you definitely start to get a sense of it, and you'll be timing it yourself automatically by feeling. It's less than a second, so it happens real quick. I like how much stress it adds to the game. Standing still is dangerous when lots of enemies are in the arena, so you can't let the arena fill up with enemies. Forcing the action to slow down will not work for everyone. You can't rely on quickly attacking the enemies to get out of a bind. The second, and my favorite part of Warp Thru, is the characters. Instead of changing weapons with each crate, like in Super Crate Box, the characters have different weapons. There are five different characters, and the story mode shifts between them. So, for example, the first character you play as, Charlotte, has a super punch. It's simple to control as you wait a moment and then attack in the direction you move. The next character, 3, has a gun that is more difficult to use. When you stop moving, the gun spins around, and when you move next, the gun fires. While it's powerful because it has long range, the aiming can be frustrating. In the heat of the moment, trying to be precise to kill the enemies is a struggle. Also, the gun aims in the opposite direction you last moved in, and that throws me off every time. These characters keep the game interesting. Each has their own way to play, especially the ones I didn't cover here. Another thing I found interesting in Warp Thru is the weekly challenge. What the heck is so interesting about a weekly challenge? Well, it's exactly what you expect with online leaderboards. But before you play, they ask you to accept their privacy policy. This is the first time I've seen something like this in an indie game. I wonder if it's because GDPR. Rucat, the developer, is in the Netherlands. Further, I imagine we'll start seeing more of this since getting your name on the online leaderboards identifies you. Overall, Warp Thru is a basic game that's derivative as hell, but still fun. I like games that have something unique about them, even if they lack that polish. I'm having quite a difficult time trying to finish this game out. It's pretty short, but the last level, or what I assume to be the last level, is really kicking my butt, and it is super hard.
Hello, thanks for watching. Like the video if you liked it. Subscribe even. Thanks.